Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms. This morning we're going to talk about problem areas and how to fill them up with flowers.
That's right. Well, and we're talking about ground cover specifically. Uh-huh. So maybe you have a lawn that just isn't doing what it should do. Maybe it doesn't get enough sun. Or maybe you have a slope and you're tired of mowing that thing when it comes, you know, in the middle of the summertime and everything's just going to town.
Well, those are two really good reasons. Like, I don't have to mow the hill.
There you go. Right? I've had to do that before, so I quite understand. A lot of people have used English ivy in the past, yeah. And we're trying to get away from that a little bit because this is a plant that can become invasive.
Right. So it's a plant that, I mean, I've had it around the house, and it needs to be controlled.
Right. It does its job, but it can get out.
So if you don't want to do a lot of messing around with it all summer long, to keep it where you want it.
Right.
Don't go that route.
And Pacas sandra's been used a lot, and mm-hmm. it's still a great ground cover. It stays evergreen. But again, we're just looking for a few different things.
Now, this little guy over here, I've got some of this in my yard. It was actually a mistake.
Okay.
But it can be a ground cover in the right place.
Sure. You just have to watch where it's going to be. This is Liriope spicata. There are two other grassy little short guys like this that will do a little bit better. Maybe don't get out of hand as fast. The Liriope muscari, and there's also Ophiopogon, a great little monkey grass.
They stay in place.
They do. And they
this
both handle...
This one will spread like crazy.
And they'll handle sun or shade, so mm-hmm. there are definitely some things to choose from.
So read the labels on Liriope.
Now, you said you had had one of these variegated English ivies, and that didn't get quite out of hand as much.
No, it seems to be easy to control. It winters over. I'm not sure. Now, in my house, it's kind of in a protected area.
Okay.
But it fills up beautifully, and it looks gorgeous every
Very
summer.
Good.
Yeah. So it's like ivy. I don't think it's quite as bad as English ivy. But it still needs to, I need to trim it back a little bit.
Yeah, there. Not a bad thing to do.
Yeah.
And that's true with a lot of these ground covers. This is one of the ground cover euonymus. This really stays nice and low.
Now, this is not the euonymus shrub.
Right. This is, you can see it doesn't have the real woodiness that mm-hmm. like a Manhattan green euonymus
right.
would or something, but it's a nice plant. And I know you've grown this, and I've had some friends that have had the same experience you have.
This, again, came with a house plant.
Okay.
You know, like a variety of flowers, and they all died, as they do in our house.
No.
We threw the thing outside, and it took off, and now it's completely filled under a tree that was a problem because of all the shade, and it's spread into all my white pines.
No, oh, very
and
nice.
And it's terrific. It's answering a question.
A nice surprise.
Fulfilling a problem here. It does well. Looks a little ratty in the spring. Some of it dies back, but it bounces
right back.
And it doubles in size.
Very good. Yeah,
quickly.
We have that happen here just in our containers. Now, this is sweet woodruff or galium. This is a great little flower. This stays all winter long a little bit. It gets a darker green in the shade.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a juga. Now, a juga I've had in my front lawn where it's been a weed because it sort of took over in an area where I did want it, but I just moved it to my backyard where I did want it, and it's worked out beautifully.
Okay, and here's a nice little plant. This almost looks like it belongs in a rock garden.
That's cool. This is another form of a juga. And what's nice about a juga is you do have that growth all summer long, spring, summer, and fall. But in the wintertime, you can take a rake and rake leaves over it. It stays nice and short. Doesn't
right.
hurt a thing.
Now, if you get, these are for sunny plants. This one's called stone crop.
Right, that's sedum, and this is another variety. This one stays evergreen. This is John Creech. Angelina will give you this great color, but doesn't stay evergreen. Green.
Yeah, all right, so if I were to take some of these and say I've got to fill an area 30 foot by 30 foot, how many of these is it going to take? I'm not going to put you
right.
have you do the math.
No, I can do that. 900. Yeah, I'm good.
You know, you have to, you know, plant something like this every 2 feet or 1 foot or
you know,
what?
It depends how fast you want it. I'd probably start with a small area and plant them about a foot apart. I might even consider going back and separating that out myself the following year to get some
to get more of them.
To get
yes.
going.
Okay.
But really, in a lot of the established beds, it's going to take you a little while to get it going. But we do recommend that you go ahead and get the soil ready just like you would for a lawn. Get some mm-hmm. good organic matter going. Whenever you plant these, take them out of the pot, loosen the roots like we always talking about, and give them a nice plant starter fertilizer, something high in phosphorus that's going to just let them get going right
mm-hmm.
away.
Now, and then year to year to year, keep fertilizing them to encourage them to go, 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 right?
Exactly, and watch that water in the spring. Make sure this year we certainly have gotten plenty, but some years we may not. And just that first year to establish them, make sure you're getting out there and they're getting about an inch of water a week. After the first year, they pretty much take care of themselves.
But it may take 2 or 3 years for the effect you're looking for to really start taking hold.
Exactly, we say that a lot with perennials. First year they sleep, second year they creep, third year they leap. So they just take off, and after
okay.
that you're good to go.
All these little sayings.
I know, isn't it great?
Carrie, thanks for informing us today
about
alternatives to grass and lawns, ground covers, and problem areas. Next Sunday, we'll talk about more in your Sunday Gardener. We'll see you then.
If you have a garden question, send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go to our website, WBAL-TV.